Now we will see what this book contains, how it contains the Torah, Injil and everything. Surah Al-Imran 3 and Ayah 7. هُوَ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ مِنْهُ آيَةٌ مُحْكَمَاتٌ هُنَّ أُمُّ الْكِتَابِ وَأُخَرُ مُتَشَابِهَاتٌ فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ زَيْغٌ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ مَا تَشَابَهَ مِنْهُ ابْتِغَاءَ الْفِتْنَةِ وَابْتِغَاءَ تَأْوِيلِهِ وَمَا يَعْلَمُ تَأْوِيلَهُ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَالرَّاسِخُونَ فِي الْعِلْمِ يَقُولُونَ آمَنَّا بِهِ كُلٌّ مِنْ عِنْدِ رَبِّنَا وَمَا يَذَّكَّرُ إِلَّا أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. It is He who has revealed Al-Kitab, the book, over you. From it are muhkamat, governing ayahs. They are the mother of the book. And others are mutashabiyat, resembling ayahs, signs. So in those whose hearts is a deviation, they follow the resemblance from it, seeking its captivation and its interpretation. And no one knows its interpretation except Allah. And those who are stable in knowledge, they say, we believe with it all. It's from the nearness of our Lord. And no one remembers except those who possess the core, the innermost part of anything. Now, it is saying, هُوَ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ. I've got a kitab in my hand. Now, when Allah says, هُوَ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ, means it is He who has revealed the book or sent down the book. Is it all right? But what we understand, meaning what is in front of me, are the words. A book is open and these words there. When it is revealed, the book, what is written there, is I got the book. If it is not revealed, I don't get the book. For example, we were outside this hall and a person who has not entered this hall at this moment, I'm standing here, this gentleman and this, all this set up. And he's thinking outside and assuming what's going on inside. A disco party. Somebody said, no, they're having a boxing match. Everybody outside having their own opinions about what's going on in the room. So somebody walks in inside and sees everything. And then explains to the people, it is revelation. You understand? So the problem is that people are standing outside, meaning outside the book Quran, and giving, sermons. So when these written words are revealed over you, the book, meaning the words or the book is revealed over you, then you understand what the book is. Like I read few verses, something is revealed over you. Come on. So that was written before also. So revelation is something what is revealed over you from the book. So Allah says, هُوَ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ مِنْهُ آيَةٌ مُحْكَمَاتٌ. In the book, there are verses. There are verses, they are governing verses. We have to govern by them. And the others are mutashabiyat or similar verses. So we will divide in understanding what are the muhkamat verses and what are the mutashabihat verses. First, what are the muhkamat verses? So we go further, next page, and we read here, Surah Maida 43 ayat. وَكَيْفَ يُحَكِّمُونَكَ وَعِنْدَهُمُ التَّوْرَةِ فِيهَا حُكْمُ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ يَتَوَلَّوْنَ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ وَمَا أُولَٰئِكَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And how can they govern you, and a Torah, the law, is near them? In the Torah, is the hukum or the governance of Allah. Hukum Allah. Then after they turn away, they are not with the believers. Now in the Torah, the law, are the hukum of Allah. The governance of Allah. The Torah contains the governance of Allah. Now, when that governance is written on an ayah, it's muhkam ayat. Or many ayahs, muhkamat ayats. So all the muhkamat ayats are the governing ayahs, and that is the Torah, the mother of the book. This book contains verses that are hukum of Allah. Where are the hukum Allah? In the Torah, in the law. In the Torah, the law, translated law. So the ayahs that are like establish the salah, go for Hajj, you know, these are the muhkamat ayahs. So these ayahs are the muhkamat ayahs, the hukum of Allah, and that is the Torah. And that is the mother of the book. Torah, do you understand? Law. And what is the law? In the law is in the Torah. He says, وَكَيْفَ يُحَكِّمُنَكَ يُحَكِّمُنَكَ وَعِنْدَهُمُ التَّوْرَةِ فِيهَا حُكْمُ اللَّهِ. In the Torah is حُكْمُ اللَّهِ. You don't have to go to the Bible. We are describing, discussing or reading from the book. In the book are muhkumat ayat or the governing ayats. And these governing ayats is called Torah. Because Allah says in the Torah is the حُكْم of Allah or the governance of Allah. So all ayahs who containing the governance are muhkamat ayat, are the governing ayat, the governing ayats. So we understand this book of Allah, this book of Allah contains muhkamat ayat, the governing ayats. And other place Allah said the hukum of Allah is known as Torah. So the all the ayahs that Allah governed us, ordered us to govern, are the muhkumat ayat, the governing ayahs, and they are the mother of the book, Torah. So Torah is the mother of the book. And in what is in the Torah? The governing ayahs. You can read further in Maida 45. وَكَتَبْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ فِيهَا أَنَ النَّفْسَ بِالنَّفْسِ وَالْعَيْنَ بِالْعَيْنِ وَالْأَنْفَ بِالْأَنْفِ والأذن بالأذن والسن بالسن والجروح قصاص فمن تصدق به فهو كفارة له ومن لم يحكم بما أنزل الله فأولئك هم الظالمون. And now here Allah says, and we have written in it a Torah on them, that is soul with a soul, an eye is with an eye, and a nose is with a nose, and an ear is with an ear, and tooth is with a tooth, and there is the relation of the wounds, physical injuries or the hurts of the one. So one who gives charity with it, then he has atonement, amendment is for him. And who does not govern with what Allah has revealed, then they are the zalimun, the oppressors. In this verse, if you note again, where is the Torah? Wakatabna. We have written on you, mankind. Look. وَكَتَبْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ فِيهَا. We have written in it the Torah on them, on people. So all mankind, on them Torah is written. And we are searching the Torah in the Bible. It is written on you. The soul is with the soul. And the eyes are not taking a vengeance. It doesn't say, you see, this is Allah's law. If you hurt somebody, you will be hurt. Allah doesn't, you take a revenge. This is not here written. His soul is with the soul. And eye, meaning is you hurt the person, somebody's eye, your eye will be hurt. You break somebody's tooth, law is like this. By God Almighty, He will take the vengeance. If I kill somebody, somebody kills me or my brother, so if I kill that, I'm doing the wrong act. I'm not supposed to do it. So, but if somebody kills my brother, I have to take blood money or anything, but I cannot kill him. Because if I kill him, I've done the same act. So in the Quran is, the soul is with the soul, and eyes with an eye, and nose with the nose, and the ears with the ear, and the tooth is with the tooth, and there is a relation of the wounds, physical injuries or hurt. So who gives charity with it, that he has atonement, amendment is for him. Who does not govern with what Allah has revealed, they are the zalim. Meaning is, you can take blood money if you are hurt. But you are not supposed to kill back. You are not supposed to kill or break his tooth or eye. This is the Torah written on everybody. Torah written on everybody. And that is the mother of the book. I'm not saying it's written there. You can verify. Now who governed with the Torah? Surah Al-Maida 5:44 verse. Inna anzalna at-Tawra fiha hudan wa nur. Ya'kum bi an-nabiyyun alladhina aslamu lil ladina hadu war-rabbaniyun wal-ahbar bima istuhfizu min kitabillah wa kanu alayhi shuhada fala taqshabu an-nasa waqshawn wa la tashtaru bi ayati thamanan qalila wa man lam ya'kum bima anzala Allah fa ulaika humul kafirun. Surely, who revealed? Surely we have revealed the Torah. Don't forget this, we, God Almighty, is saying we have revealed the Torah, not a single state in the whole book. They are saying that the Pentateuch is the Torah, mankind. The first five books, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, and Numbers, Deuteronomy, is the Torah that Moses spoke about. Here he said, we have revealed the Torah. Who said? God Almighty. We have revealed the Torah. In it is the governance, containing the governing ayahs. And Ya'kum bi an-nabiyyun alladhina aslamu. And the Nabi, the prophets in plural, not only Moses, every prophet governed with it, and the Rabbanim, the lords, and the Ahbar, the scholars, they were governing for the Hadu, the Jews. So that means Allah revealed the Torah, Inna anzalna Torah, fiha hudan wa nur, in it is guidance and light. We have revealed the Torah, God Almighty is saying it. Not this Bible. Torah, the law. And they are there governing ayahs. And one I've read, Wakatabna, and it is written on us. Don't forget. An eye is with an eye, tooth is with a tooth. So it is we. Now it says, all the prophets in plural govern with the Torah. And for the Jews. Surely we revealed the Torah, the law, hukum, the governance, containing the governing ayahs, in it is guidance and light. The prophets who govern with it, for those who are Hadu, the Jews, and Rabbaniyun, the lords, and Ahbar, the scholars, govern with it. With what they were required to become Hafiz, those who memorize from the book of Allah. They were asked to memorize. The lords and scholars were asked to memorize the book of Allah, Torah, Mokamat Ayats. No? We must tuhfizu min kitabillah. From the book of Allah, they were memorized. So they memorized. Where is this book? I'm telling you, this book is preserved in the human disk or human tablet. It is preserved because they were asked to memorize. So the book in the paper form, man brought it, and they're looking in the ancient books, they are finding contradiction. But what is memorized is exact what is here in the world. The memorization is the criteria which were done by before. Bimastuhfizum in kitabillah wa kanu alayhi shuhada, they were witness over it. Because they memorize it. And you can see in the whole world, with all different nationalities and all languages of the world, people are reciting the Quran without understanding, no problem. But it is preserved. All over the world, all nationalities of the world. The book you find, they are going into finding manuscripts of the Bible or the manuscripts of the Quran. It doesn't make a difference for the Muslim world because it's God's book is preserved. Because He wrote it. Because He wrote it, no? On us, it is preserved. It is preserved. You can't change a dot because it is memorized. And if I speak, if I read wrong, you will correct. He will correct. He will correct. Anybody can correct. That is so much the positive memory. You are standing in a salah, and the imam makes a mistake. People speak behind the back. So you know you can't say anything beyond Quran. This is like in the Quran. What? No. Sorry. But if you say in the Bible, yes, I'm talking about Jehovah's Bible. Or I'm talking revised standard version of the Bible. It's not there. So you compare different books, different ideologies. So now, but what happened to the memorization? Allah says in Surah Jumu'ah 62 and 5, مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ حُمِّلُوا التَّوْرَاةَ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَحْمِلُهَا كَمَثَلِ الْحِمَارِ يَحْمِلُ أَسْفَارًا بِئْسَ مَثَلُ الْقَوْمِ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. The example of those lords and scholars who have been carrying the Torah, the law, the hukum, the governance of the containing all the governing ayahs, they memorized or they holding it, they did not carry it. They carry like as an example of a donkey is carrying like a donkey. Bad is, Allah says, traveling with load. Why Allah is calling them donkey? The memorizing people who have memorized this book all over the world, they don't know Torah is in this book. Is it a fact or not? It is a fact or not, the memorization people who have memorized this book, they don't know the Torah is muhkamat ayat. So they are holding like a donkey. And they are traveling all around the world, giving big, big sermons. They don't know Torah, Old Testament is there. They are saying, and what they are reading in the mind, they don't know. So Allah said, that is what happened. And He says, for the kadhabu, bisa mithal mathal ladina qawma ladina kadhabu bi ayatillah. Those who falsify, those who deny the eyes of Allah, these donkeys. They say, wallahu la yahdil qawma zalimin. Allah will not guide those who are oppressors. You have memorized this book. You are the scholar. You are the ahbar. I am to reading. I didn't memorize. I am reading from here. So people who have memorized it, they are going all over the world and reading it for other people and telling something else. Not reading from here. So Allah says, مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ حُمِّلُوا التَّوْرَةَ. So Allah says, Torah is mentioned 18, what the conclusion is, that Torah is mentioned 18 times in the book or Al-Quran. The Torah is the revelation from Allah. Torah is a guidance and light. Torah is the governance of Allah. All the prophets governed with the Torah, not only Moses, Muhammad, and Muhammad, the seal of the prophets, governed with Torah, the law. If the people will not govern from a Torah, the law, then they are the rejectors and the oppressors. This is what Torah is, the governing ayahs, the governance of ayahs. Now we will see what Injil is, gospel. In Surah Maida 46, وَقَفَّيْنَا عَلَىٰ آثَارٍ بِعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمَ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ التَّوْرَةِ وَآتَيْنَاهُ الْإِنْجِيلَ فِيهِ هُدًى وَنُورٌ وَمُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ التَّوْرَةِ وَهُدًى وَمَوْعِظَةً لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. And we, again we, who is this we? You forget easily, you know, we are reading. We made the falling over the effects with Isa, Jesus, the son of Mary, confirming from a Torah, the law, that is hukum, the governance of the containing, I'm reading the brackets as well, containing the governing ayah signs, that is between his two hands. And we gave him Injil. Who gave Injil to Jesus? God. We gave him Injil, the good news, in it is guidance and light. And confirming from the Torah, the law, that is hukum, governance of Allah, containing all the governing eyes, that is between his two hands. And a guidance as a sermon for muttaqeen, those who guard. You know, the amazing part of this verse is, how many people can read Arabic? One? Come on. Okay, 60-70%. Okay, I will show you in English and just don't read the brackets now. First we read the Arabic. You see, in the Arabic you will see وَقَفَّيْنَا عَلَىٰ آثَارٍ بِعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمَ. Have you seen this? Okay. Then see مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ التَّوْرَاتِ. Have you seen this? And now you go two lines, don't read the second line, now read again. وَمُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ التَّوْرَاتِ. You see, the same words are written again. Can you see this? Okay, what it means is, Allah said, we gave Jesus the Injil. And the Injil, gospel or good news, confirms मुसद्दी कलने में बहना दे व्हाट इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू और व्हाट इज बिटवीन योर हैंड्स. द इंजील कन्फर्म द इंजील इज एज लाइट एंड गाइडेंस एंड इट कन्फर्म्स व्हाट इज इन द तौरा इंजील. ओके दिस इज द मीनिंग. एंड देन अल्लाह से वी गेव हिम इंजील दैट इज गाइडेंस लाइट एंड इंजील ऑल्सो डू द सेम थिंग कन्फर्म्स व्हाट इज बिटवीन हिज टू हैंड्स व्हाट इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ हिम. Jesus also came and confirmed the Torah, and Injil itself came and Injil what Injil was given, it is also confirming from the Torah. It says, "Musaddiqan lima bayna yaday min at-Tawrah wa hudan wa mau'izatan lil-muttaqin," and it is Injil is a guidance and a sermon to for the muttaqin of the Torah. Jesus when gave sermon. Of the governing ayahs or the Mahkamat ayahs, sermon on the governing ayahs or the Mahkamat ayahs is the Injil. If I speak or deliver a talk on the governing verses, so it will be a sermon of the Torah called Injil. I hope you understand. Okay. Torah means the governing verses, all the orders where Allah says establish the salah like this, okay, or fast and stuff. So if I give a sermon on the Torah, so Allah says this is Injil, the sermon giving on the Mahkamat Ayat or the Torah, confirming from the Torah, Jesus was given the, Jesus came and confirmed the Torah. And further Allah says, we gave him Injil, it also guidance and light, and it is a sermon of the Torah. Musaddiqan lima bayna yaday. I mean, those verses that contains the hukum or the governing ayahs, if I give a sermon on that, the Jesus gave the sermon on the Mahkamat ayat, on the governing ayahs. You follow what I'm saying? Governing ayahs. When the sermon is given on the governing ayahs, it is Injil or gospel. That's good news. Okay? I hope you follow. Why I'm saying it? Because you read, if you read in the Arabic, it repeats twice. وَقَيْفَيْنَا عَلَىٰ آثَارٍ بِعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمْ. And on the effects, Isa ibn Maryam came. And what he did? مُصَدِّقَ لِمَا بَيْنَا يَدَيْهِ مِنَ التَّوْرَاتِ. He confirmed from the Torah. Isa, Jesus. Jesus is a human being. A messenger of God. He confirms from the Torah. Okay? Now, وَآتَيْنَا إِنْجِيل. And we gave him Injil. فِيهِ هُدًى وَنُورٌ. In it is guidance and light. Now, what does Injil do? Does وَمُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ التَّوْرَاتِ. Injil is also doing the same thing. But further it says, وَهُدًى وَمَعْوِذَةً لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. And it is a guidance and a sermon for the guarded ones. Sermon of what? The Mahkamat Ayat or the Torah. Torah is the mother of the book, and Torah as law is the mother of the book. And if I give a sermon, or anybody, or Jesus gave a sermon of the Mahkamat Ayat, or the governing ayat, is the Torah, or the Injil. If I'm giving a sermon on Torah, I hope you understand it's being difficult, too difficult. Allah has made it easy for you to understand and remember.
It's good news.
Yeah, it's good news. Yes, yes,
the
good news, you offer prayers and you do this and you'll get Jannah.
Yeah, it's just good news.
That's all good news. And why to focus Mahkamat Ayat? Because there are people who are getting Mutashabihat Ayat. So Jesus was giving the sermons on Mahkamat Ayat. So you correct yourself. Yeah, okay. So now further I says in 47, Wal yakum ahlul injil bimanz Allah fi wa man lam yakum bimanz Allah fa ulaikamul fasiqoon. Let the people of Injil govern with what Allah has revealed in it, and if they do not govern what Allah has revealed, they are the liberals. Now, who are the people of Injil? Come on, who is the people of Injil? Yeah, I understand, but look at the verses, find out from the verses. No, just look at the verse, previous verse. What's the English word, Arabic word? Muttaqeen. Muttaqeen. You understand? The ayah says, وَهُدَمْ وَمَعُوِذَةً لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. So those who guard, ذَلِكْ كِتَابْ لَا رَيْبَ فِي هُدَى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. Those who guard. So that means those who guard, they are the people of Injil. So Allah said, وَلْيَحْكُمْ أَهْلُ الْإِنْجِيلِ. And let the people of Injil should govern with what Allah has revealed. And if they do not govern, they are the liberals. They are taking liberty. So you right, in a way you are right. We Muslim are the people of Injil. But the question is, you must know what type of we people. Are we guarding it? Are we really guarding our psyche by the book or the Injil? Then only. If I'm not doing, I'm just, you know, in a way we can say the Muslim world, right? So now you have come to know Quran, you have come to know book, you have come to know Torah and Injil. Now there is Ahsan Hadith also. I have read in Al-Imran 3 and 7. Huwa alladhi, I'm reading not the whole ayat, just a portion of an ayah. Huwa alladhi anzal al-kitab minhu ayatun muhkamat hunna ummul kitab wa ukhra mutashabihat. So in this verse we come to know that the muhkamat ayat, the governing ayats, is the Torah, the law, and that is the mother of the book. Okay. And when the mother of book, Torah, mother of the book, somebody give a sermon on that, is Injil, the gospel. Right? Now, what is this وَوَوْخَرُ مُتَشَابِيَاتِ. But there are ayat, they are resembling. You know, somebody say, this guy resembled. So they say this guy. So resemble means, I'm not saying, but resemble. So that's why I'm saying, they say allegorical, and you know, mutashabi means simply resembling. Very clear, no confusion. Now, next verse is Surah 39, and we see what are the resembling verses. 39, Surah Zumur 39, 23 ayat. Allahu nazzala asal hadith. كِتَابًا مَتَشَابِيًا مَثَانِي تَقْشَعِرُ مِنْهُ جُلُودُ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ ثُمَّ تَلِينُ جُلُودُهُمْ وَقُلُوبُهُمْ إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ ذَلِكَ هُدَى اللَّهِ يَهْدِي بِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَمَنْ يُضْلِلِ اللَّهُ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ هَادٍ. Allah has revealed the most beautiful hadith, the event, a book mutashabiya, resembling, repeating itself. Those who fear from their Lord, their skins shiver from it, and then their skins and their hearts soften towards the remembrance of Allah. That is the guidance of Allah. He guides whom He wills with it, and to whom Allah leads astray. As for whom, though, there is no one who can guide. Now, what is the mutashabiya? Allahu nazzala arsal hadith. Allah has revealed or sent down arsal, the most beautiful hadith, means the narration or event. There are hadiths in the world, 6 of the Sunnis and the 4 of the Shias. But Allah is also narrated the most beautiful hadith. They are also hadiths, most beautiful hadiths, Allah is revealed. And if you read the book, there are governing ayahs and there are narrations of Moses, narration of Jesus. So Allah says, Hal ataka hadith of Musa. You're looking for Muhammad Rasulullah hadith. Have you listened to Musa hadith? You don't want to know. Hal ataka hadith Musa, the maximum number of hadith in the Quran is of Musa. You know that? Second is Ibrahim al-Islam. Did you know that? And Ibrahim al-Islam is the Uswa Hasna. Did you know that? No. You don't know. You are looking at hadith outside of the Quran. You don't believe in hadith? Of course I do believe. I do believe. Of all the prophet hadith, where Allah is described about Moses, about Abraham, about Noah, about Yunus, about Isa, Jesus, peace be upon all the prophets, and about the skies, how He created the earth, and the mountains, and the galaxies, and the stars, and the plants, and the animals, what not. They are all narrations. When you read the ayahs, you will see a governance ayah and then a narration. Adam narration. And people are always asking about Narasimha Rao. It's like stories. When you're a child, you're at school, when you're very small, the mother says, there was a king and a queen, but a soja, and then this and that. You know, the children are being narrated stories from their mothers. So we are adults, we still like to love stories. So whenever the ayat is talking about a narration, you think it's a story. It's not a story, it's telling you something very important. That's Asl Hadith. And the most beautiful Hadith. And Allah defines that a book, Mudashar, those who fear from the Lord, their skins shiver from it, and their skins and their hearts soften towards the remembrance of Allah. That is the guidance of Allah. He guides whom we will. Of the narrations of Allah's ayahs in the book. Believe me, if you watch a movie, and everybody watch movies, and when you see a horror film, or when you see a romantic film, any film, it affects your soul. Somebody is not watching you and somebody is looking at your face and you're watching a movie. Especially women and men also. What are the... And then sometimes different shades of movies you see and different emotions are reflected on your face. And when you read an ayah, nothing happens. Nothing happens. This is the guidance. If you're reading an event of Ibrahim al-Islam, or Nuh al-Islam, or Dawud al-Islam, or Sulaiman al-Islam, or Jesus, or whoever narration, or Allah's creation narration, and the Qiyamah, and the afterlife, and the fire, and the Jannah, everything you read, and alone in the night, and if is a picture is made in your mind, in true sense, you will feel this. Those who fear from the Lord, their skins shiver from their skins, and their skins and their hearts soften towards the remembrance of Allah. But that Shaitan has taken the majority temperament from us. So we are more inclined to the movies. Crying for these movies. And have you seen that one? It really affected my heart, you know. Did you see that one? Did you? So we are living in a fantasy world. And you know they are acting, they are not real. But it affects you. But what about these ayahs, the gigantic messengers and prophets' narrations, real narrations? Only one I give you example, when Ibrahim al-Islam is the father of religion. Do you know that? Ibrahim is a messenger and a prophet. Ibrahim is the imam, the leader. Ibrahim is al-Islam, the friend. Al-Islam is a friend. And what not. And he's saying, Rabbana waj'alna muslimani lak. O our Lord, make me Muslim for you. You can imagine this? For me, it's the most heart-shivering thing. I am calling Muslim and calling other people non-Muslims and saying labels to other people and fighting and killing in the name of Islam. And what about Ibrahim Islam and Ismail Islam raise the foundation of the Kaaba and they say, O our Lord, make both of us Muslims. In your sight, laka, muslimaini laka. Wa min dhuryatina ummatam muslimatan lak. And you raise a nation Muslim for you. We are making Muslim of each other. Qadiani Muslim, Ahmadi Muslim, Shia Muslim, Sunni Muslim, Deobandi Muslim. Are you Muslim for Allah? Muslim for Allah you have to be. Then you, and this is not a political religious, I'm telling you, this is direct relation from God. I'm speaking so many, we did this and we, it is directly God and you, no one else. You can't blame the Satan also, because Allah explores the personality of Satan. I have delivered a separate talk on Satan, how he misguides. Because it is the only book, Quran, that exposes the Satan. So Allah says, فَإِذَا قَرَاتَ الْقُرْآنَ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. Whenever you read the Quran, take Allah's protection from the Shaitan, the devil. Because he won't let you open the book. He is the most the topest person doing his beautiful job given by God Almighty. So up till now we have read what is Quran, the reading. We have read what is Al-Kitab, the book given to all the prophets, and what the book contains. The book contains narration, events, Ahsan al-Hadith, Tawrah, the law, Muhkamat ayahs, and the Mutashabiyat ayahs are those events and narration of Ibrahim al-Islam, Musa al-Islam, Nuh al-Islam, Dawud al-Islam, all the narration or events, Ahsan al-Hadith, Hadith of Musa, peace be upon him, Hadith or narration of the Qiyamah. So these are all narration. You read the book, you'll find many narrations in the book. They are all astral hadith. And the governing ayahs are the Tawrat, the law, the mother of the book.